Hello, it's Polish Paul VR. Welcome to the channel, and once again we gathered here to do freshest PSVR news in the village. But before I start, I know there meant to be live stream yesterday with Golem giveaway results. Sadly, my busy life didn't allow me to do anything yesterday. So listen, you can still enter Golem giveaway, go to latest episode of PSVR Super Show, and that's all the instructions. But we're gonna have live stream this Thursday, and that's when I'm gonna announce Golem winners, and that's when you'll be able to enter Pistol Whip giveaway as well, which gonna be nice because of course Pistol Whip is super awesome. So that's what's happening in the future. The live stream will be about 8:30 PM UK time or 3:30 PM Eastern time, US time. Yes, I think I remembered it now. I don't know, but anyway, around that time. Okay, never mind, let's just jump into the news, and today we're gonna start from Undead Citadel. So this is a game that since announcement got very good. People saw the trailer and was thinking like, okay, yes, this is pretty awesome. What we're seeing is physically based combat. Enemies you can throw from the wall to the well or somewhere. You can chop their limbs off, chop their heads off, cut them to bits, you've got magic and stuff. Also, it's got proper campaign, not just arena fighting, but like a campaign, you're going through the levels, very nice narration. So they're doing everything right. But what's happening is the game meant to come out in Q2 2020. As we know, that's got delayed. We entered now Q3. So on the Discord, people been asking them like, all right, now it's August, is the game still happening in Q3, what's going on? And basically what the developer said, Q3 is not even given, that's their estimate, but what they're saying that they hoping to release this year. So, you know, hoping might not mean it's even gonna happen, so we might even see it in the 2021, nobody knows. I think what's happened is since announcement, they saw how big interest is in this game. Of course, studio is not the biggest as well, and they tried to add a lot of good stuff to the game. I remember a while ago now, they did like a pre-alpha where some people had a chance to play the game. They've had very, very good feedback, but also in this feedback, they was like, yes, we better make some things looking nicer and playing better. So what they did, they added proper physics, proper weight to the weapons, proper weight to the enemies. So it looks like they managed to make it a much, much bigger game, but sadly, of course, for us, well, sadly because it takes more time, but good for us, very nice, you know, niceness for us is the fact that the game gonna be better when it releases. So of course, stay tuned to the channel. As soon as I know, I'll be letting you know, but as of now, the latest info is that Q3 is just the estimate and the game might come even a bit later. Okay, anyway, next story, jumping on, moving on, we're gonna talk about next PlayStation State of Play, which will happen this Thursday, 4 PM US time, 9 PM UK time, which, as you noticed, it's kind of allowed when I be doing my live stream, because I be live streaming it on this channel, so make sure you hop in and we can chat together and see what Sony gonna show us, and they kind of hinted on what they gonna be showing us, because they said, yes, listen, this next State of Play gonna be just concentrating on PlayStation 4 and PlayStation VR upcoming games from the third party developers, so nothing from their first party studios, so I don't know, nothing like Sony's own exclusives. But maybe finally we're gonna hear, I don't know, about Baby Hunt. This got announced ages ago and never happened. Maybe gonna be there some information about Minecraft VR. And Minecraft VR is something you want, so make sure you hop into the channel so we can watch it together and find out. Or maybe what I'm hoping of is some brand new games announcements. So this State of Play sounds like it's gonna be good. In past, I've been saying on the channel that Sony withheld some announcements from the developers because they wanted to do their own State of Play, but it was all rumors, and now we know it's all confirmed, it's gonna happen. So I'm excited for it, I hope you are excited, because things been a bit quiet, and it's been a bit quiet because Sony kind of done it on purpose, so now something gonna happen, and I'm assuming it's gonna be pretty awesome, so let's just check out, let's find out. Anyway, next story, and of course talking still about PlayStation VR, because that's what this channel does, but we're gonna talk about PlayStation VR on PlayStation 5. So what's gonna happen is they told us what they're doing, what they're planning, how the thing's gonna work. So all your PSVR setup, your camera, your headset, your Move controllers, your aim controller, your lacing wheels, your hotas, that's all gonna work on PlayStation 5, which is very nice. But when it comes to the camera, you're gonna need special adapter, but don't panic, they said, calm down, people. This adapter gonna be for totally free. Now, how you gonna get your hands on this adapter? I have no idea, unless it's just gonna be included in PlayStation 5 box, I don't know. But also, you know, it's nice, it's for free, so your camera will be work. As we know, backwards compatibility gonna be working fine. I know in past they said most titles work, and they said few titles don't. Don't worry about it. My best guess is those few titles will be those games what using kind of mobile apps or something like that. That's what I'm thinking. But anyway, which sadly is persistence, but I might be wrong. But anyway, your camera will be working. So everything you own now will be working fine, apart from 3D Router, because it might work, it might not. I don't know. Sony didn't say, they said most peripherals will be work, but some don't. I'm assuming maybe 3D Router sadly won't. No idea at all. But speaking about 3D Router, I know some of you got kind of screwed by them, and they still didn't send you Ground Gripper, which is very bad on them. So if you're planning to order now, just wait till they sort themselves out. And also wait for confirmation that it's gonna work on PlayStation 5. Anyway, I barely use mine. But moving on to the camera issue on PlayStation 5. So what I gonna do, I gonna buy this brand new camera. I already done video about it, because even though there is no official specs, the rumor saying yes, it's gonna be higher resolution, and also it's gonna be higher frame rate. And that's all gonna adapt to giving us better tracking, and that's something what we need. Of course, when the things got occluded, it's still gonna be as bad as it's now. You can't like do 360 degrees turns and stuff like that, but maybe this little wobble will be sorted and everything gonna work better. I have no idea. But check out the Move controllers, PlayStation 3, PlayStation 4 and PlayStation 5, spawning 3 generations and still going strong. This must be Sony's most successful and most longest supported peripheral ever. Who knew when they first released? But anyway, that's some very good news, and of course that indicates that Sony is still gonna support PSVR on PS5. As we knew they will, because they already announced, but they keeping quiet about upcoming future model of PSVR, even though we kind of know that it's gonna happen. I'm expecting it to be still feathered, so you still feathered? You know, cable plugged to the USB or somewhere, I don't know. But also I expect to have 360 degrees tracking, I expect to have nice controllers, maybe finger tracking, and I expect much higher resolution. I wouldn't go for 4K, because I'm assuming they're gonna still try to keep it in this lower price range, but 1440p, very, very possible. Anyway, also, if you like what you're seeing, then please press a like, because it does helps the channel a lot. And if you're new to the channel and are not subscribed, then subscribe. It's always better when it's more of us. And that's it, bye.